Hello friends, my next video is on Megascopic Description and Identification of Rocks, Engineering Geology Laboratory, 18 CVL 47. Myself, Ashish Desai, Assistant Professor, Department of Civil, Navadan Institute of Technology, Raichur. First, we study about what do you mean by rock. Rock is an aggregate of one or more minerals. That is, it is a combination of one or more minerals. Example, granite, which contains quartz and feldspar. In common, rock is anything which is hard and resistant. But in geological language, rock meaning is extended to include all the natural substances made of minerals. Either they are hard like granite or soft like sand or clay. Rock and stone, anything which is hard and resistant may be named as stone. But rock may be hard and or soft. So rock is nothing but aggregate of one or more minerals. Major families of rock, that is classification. There are three major families: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, and metamorphic rocks. So we will study now igneous rocks. So igneous means, it is the word derived from Latin word ignis, means fire. These rocks are formed by solidification of magma or lava. When the magma comes out from the volcano and the lava flows on the surface, okay, your igneous rocks are formed. So these are the rocks formed by solidification of magma or lava. These rocks are also known as primary or first form rocks. When magma is under surface of the earth, it is called magma. When it erupts, it is called lava. That means it is, inside it is the magma, and outside when it comes, it is lava. So in this figure you can see, so this is the magma. When it comes out, it is flow in the form of lava. Okay, by this way your igneous rock is formed. So classification of igneous rocks, there are two types: intrusive igneous rocks and extrusive igneous rocks. Intrusive means inner action, extrusive means outer action, this outside. Intrusive igneous rocks, okay, when magma is solidified or crystallized below the earth surface of earth, the igneous are formed, igneous rocks are formed. Okay, so intrusive rocks are nothing but the rocks or minerals or magma, it gets solidified or crystallized below the earth's surface. Okay, so intrusive rocks are coarse grain crystals. Extrusive rocks, when magma is forced out of the surface of earth due to certain conditions, it is solidified on the surface of earth and the rocks are formed on the surface of earth, known as extrusive igneous rocks. Intrusive means inside, extrusive means outside. Extrusive rocks are less crystalline as compared to intrusive. Classification of igneous rocks. There are two main categories based on proportion of silica and on the basis of solidification of magma. So based on silica, there are two types: acidic and basic rocks. Acidic rocks, which are having high percentage of silica, usually greater than 2/3 of the percentage or greater than 60 to 65%. They are light in color and weight. Basic rocks, which is generally less than 50% of silica. These rocks are dark in color and heavier in weight than acidic rocks. Okay. So in acidic, the silica percentage is more, than in basic, the silica percentage is less. So classification on the basis of solidification of magma. There are three types: plutonic rocks, hyperbasal rocks, volcanic rocks. Plutonic rocks, when magma is solidified below the surface of earth, the rocks formed are known as plutonic rocks. When the rocks are formed below the earth surface, it is called plutonic rocks. They are called intrusive rocks. They take long time for magma to cool and solidify in rocks. Hyperbasal rocks, When magma is solidified at short distance below the surface of earth, nearly at depth of 7 km, are known as hypabasal rocks. These rocks are also called intrusive rocks. So pluton is nothing but it is formed below the surface of earth. Hypabasal, it is formed near the surface of the earth at this depth of 7 km. And the last one is volcanic rocks. When magma is solidified on the surface of earth, the rocks are formed known as volcanic rocks. These are called extrusive rocks. So plutonic below the earth crust, volcanic above the earth crust, and hypabasal near the earth crust, that is 7 km. So next we'll study one by one about the rocks. So the first example is granite or pink granite. The nature is plutonic rock. So what do you mean by plutonic? It is formed below the earth crust, acidic. Okay, silica percentage greater than 2/3. So whatever examples or definitions I have given, if you read that, you will understand this in detail. So nature is plutonic rock, acidic, light color. Essential minerals. Essential means the important mineral present, which quartz and feldspar. Accessory means in minute amount, biotite and muscovite mica. Texture, it vary from fine to coarse grain. Equigranular texture is common. Equigranular means all the grain sizes are equal in size. Occurrence, it occurs as major intrusive bodies such as batholiths. Intrusive means formed below the earth crust. So where granite is used, it is used as a building stone, on the flooring. Name of the rock, pink granite. So the important point is the essential minerals, quartz, feldspar. It is a plutonic rock, acidic. It is formed as intrusive bodies. It is used as building stone, flooring. Next, basalt. It is a volcanic rock. Volcanic means it is formed above the earth crust. Composition basic to ultra basic, dark color. Essential minerals, augite, plagioclase, feldspar. Accessory, olivine, and etc. Texture is fine grain. Occurrence, it is formed due to lava flows. It is used as concrete aggregate, that is in your concrete mixing, along with sand and cement, road making, etc. The name is basalt. So it is a volcanic rock. Augite is the essential minerals, plagioclase, feldspar. It is a fine grain, is formed due to lava flows, and it is used in concrete aggregate and road making. The name is basalt. Next one, pumice. It is an extrusive volcanic rock, light color. Feldspar, augite, hornblende, these are the essential minerals. Quartz mica are in minute amount. Texture, fine grain, vesicular texture. It is extremely porous igneous rocks that forms during explosive volcanic eruptions. It is very lightweight in color. Extremely porous rock. It is used as an abrasive in industrial and consumer products. The name of the rock is pumice. The important point is the extrusive volcanic rock. Feldspar, augite is the essential minerals along with hornblende. It is porous in nature. It is used as an abrasive. Okay, the name is pumice. When you put this pumice rock in water, it will float. Gabbro. It is a plutonic rock. Basic magma, that is the silica percentage less than 50%. Essential minerals, plagioclase, feldspar. Accessory, hornblende, mica, biotite. So biotite mica. Texture, equigranular texture, that is grain size is equal. In this grain size is coarse to medium. Occurrence in the form of intrusive bodies. It is used as a decorative stone. Name, gabbro. The important points are plutonic rock, plagioclase, feldspar, epigranular texture in the form of intrusive rocks used as a decorative stone, name gabbro. Syenite, next one. It is a plutonic rock, light colored. The essential minerals are alkali, feldspar, accessory apatite, texture medium to coarse. It occurs in the form of intrusive igneous bodies. So most of the rock which are studied are intrusive, except the basalt, which is a volcanic rock, which is an extrusive. Uses as dimension stone for building facing and choirs. name cyanide. So in cyanide we will find alkali feldspar more. The grain size is made up to coarse and it is used for pasting of building and fires. The name is cyanide. Next we should about the sedimentary rocks. Sedimentary rocks is nothing but it is formed by consolidation and cementation of cements deposited under water. It is formed by consolidation and cementation of sediments deposited under water. So how does the formation of sediment rocks takes place? Sediment transport and deposition, ice, water and wilt. These are the transporting agents. Okay. Types of sediment rocks, clastic and non-clastic. It is also called chemical and organic. In clastic, the examples are conglomerate, breccia, sandstone, mudstone. In chemical organic, evaporite, carbonate rocks, organic. In evaporite, they are formed by due to evaporation of saline water. For gypsum example. In carbonate, it is formed basically from calcium carbonate, both by chemical leaching and by organic source. In organic form due to decomposition of organic remains under temperature and pressure, coal, lignite. So classification of sediment rocks, rudaceous, that is under clastic, rudaceous, arenaceous, argillaceous. Rudaceous rocks means the grain size greater than 2 mm. Arenaceous rocks means the grain size between 1 to 2 mm. And argillaceous rock is less than 1 mm. So the rudaceous means greater than 2 mm. Arenaceous means between 1 to 2 mm. Argillaceous means between less than 1 mm. The example are conglomerate, sandstone, shale. So particle size in sediments according to the grade, grain size and rock type. Pebble, gravel, sand, silt, clay. The classification. Non-clastic. In non-clastic, chemically formed and organically formed. Chemically formed, there is carbonate rocks, salt rocks, ferruginous rocks, siliceous rocks. Carbonate rocks. The most abundant carbonate rocks are limestone and dolomite, which are formed by chemical precipitation of calcium carbonate from seawater. Salt rocks. Evaporation is the major process involved in the deposition of chemical precipitate. The salt deposit formed by the evaporation of saline lakes are called evaporites. The principal mineral of these deposits are chlorides and sulfates of sodium, potassium, magnesium and calcium. Example is gypsum and anhydrite. This is just the classification and examples of rocks. Salt rock, gypsum, anhydrite. Ferruginous rocks. These rocks are formed by chemical precipitation of iron oxide. Such rocks contains a high proportion of iron bearing mineral such as siderite, hematite and pyrite. Siliceous deposit. These rocks are formed when silica is precipitated from water. Organically formed rocks, biochemical and organic rocks. You can see the plant fossil or imprint on the rock. Shale with plant fossil. Organically formed rocks contains organic matter because belongs to this group. Example, coal. These are called carbonaceous rocks because these are formed organically. Texture in sediment rocks, origin of grains, size of grains, shape, packing, fabric. So origin of grains, either clastic or non-clastic. Size, coarse greater than 5 mm, medium between 1 to 5 mm, fine less than 1 mm. Shape of grains, angular, subangular, sub-rounded, rounded, well sorted. Packing of sediments, open pack, densely packed, related to lithostratigraphic pressure. Fabric of grains, sediment rocks containing elongated particles and their orientation demarks the flows of sediments. structure, stratification, lamination, crossbreeding, graded bedding, ripple marks, concretionary structure, minor structure. These are the structures you find in sedimentary rocks. So first one, stratification. The deposition of sediments into layers or beds are called stratification. You can see the in this picture, bed A, B, C, D. So this is the example of stratification. Deposition of sediments into layers or beds is called stratification. Lamination. The thin bedding less than 1 centimeter in thickness is called lamination. You can see the lamination here. Lamination is found in very fine grain rocks. Cross bedding or current bedding. In this structure, minor beds or lamination lie at an angle to the planes of general stratification. Graded bedding. In graded bedding, each bed shows a gradation in grain size from coarse below to fine above. In this picture, you can see the graded bedding. From coarse to fine. Ripple marks. Usually in water you can see the ripple marks. Minor structures. In mud cracks, footprints, snake print, rain print, mud cracks. Next, we'll study one by one about the sediment rocks. The first one is red sandstone. It is a clastic rock. Okay, arenaceous. Arenaceous means grain size between 1 to 2 mm. Color variable. Essential minerals, that is quartz, greater than 90% SiO2. Accessory minerals, feldspar, mica, garnet. Texture, it is well sorted, subangular to rounded sand grains. Texture medium grained. Structure, stratification, current bedding, ripple marks. Uses building stone, road stone. Name red sandstone. The Red Fort of India is constructed from sandstone. So in this, the important points is from essential mineral is quartz. It is a clastic rock. It is an arenaceous rock. The grain size is well sorted, subangular. It is used as building stone, red stone. Road stone, the name is red sandstone. Next one is limestone, which is a calcareous rocks. Okay, it gives effervescence with dilute HCl. When you put a few drops of dilute HCl, effervescence, that is bubbles, comes out from limestone. Essential minerals, calcium carbonate, that is CaCO3, magnesium carbonate in variable amounts. Accessory minerals, silt and clay. Texture is very fine grain, compact and massive. It is a non-clastic sedimentary rock. It is used in manufacture of your cement. The name is limestone. The important points are calcareous rocks. It gives effervescence with dilute HCl. Essential mineral is calcium carbonate. It is a fine grain rock, compact and massive. It is a non-clastic sediment rock in manufacture of cement. The name is limestone. Next one is laterite. It is a residual product of weathering in hot and humid climate. Color is often red, brown or yellow. The essential minerals are clay rich in aluminum and iron oxides. It contains minor amounts of silica. In dugout, rock may be hard, compact and massive. The fresh rock, however, is porous and full of cavities. You can see the cavities in this picture, in this rock sample. It occurs due to chemical weathering of certain pre-existing rocks under favorable tropical climate, that is hot and humid climate. Uses ferruginous varieties are used for construction. Clay rich varieties are used in chemical industry. The name is laterite. Usually in coastal area, Goa and all, you will find this type of rocks. So it is a residual product of weathering. Color is often red or yellow or brown. Clay rich in aluminum or iron oxide. It is hard, compact, and massive, formed due to chemical weathering of pre-existing rocks under favorable tropical climates. Example is laterite, name of the rock. Next one is shale, which is an argillaceous rock. Argillaceous means grain size less than 1 mm. Color variable. Shales are often soft and can be scratched by knife. So the essential minerals are kaolinite, illite, montmorillonite. Accessory minerals, quartz, mica. Texture very fine with less than 0.01 mm. Structure, lamination, ripple marks. It is used in manufacture of bricks and tiles. The name is shale. So argillaceous rocks, it is an argillaceous rocks. Color variable. Minerals are kaolinite, illite, montmorillonite. Grain size less than 0.01 mm. Lamination, ripple marks. In manufacture of bricks and tiles, shale. Next, we should about the metamorphic rocks. Igneous ore, sedimentary ore. Next, metamorphic. So, meta means change. Morph means form. Change in form. Okay. The definition is a rock that has been changed from its original form, that is parent, by heat, pressure, and activity, fluid activity, into a new rock. It is a daughter rock. Okay. So, change in form of rock due to heat, pressure, and fluid activity is called your metamorphic rocks. Again, in simple definition, rocks either igneous, sedimentary, or metamorphic that have been changed in size, shape, texture, and even in mineralogy by the application of heat, pressure, and chemical active fluids. Because of heat, pressure, and chemical active fluids, where a metamorphic rock is formed from either from igneous, sedimentary, or metamorphic. So kinds of metamorphism, thermal metamorphism. Thermal means heat. So in this, heat is dominant factor. It as we go down inside the earth, the temperature increases. Okay, intrusion of magma. It is also called contact metamorphism. So in this, thermal, that is heat is dominant factor. Next one, dynamothermal metamorphism. Dynamothermal means both heat and pressure are dominant in this. They complete recrystallize with new structures. As in this figure you can see, because of the pressure, the direction of slaty cleavage has been changed. So classification based on texture and structure of minerals. Foliated, non-foliated, granular. Foliated means rocks that contain mica and ferromagnesium minerals. Minerals flatten and arrange in parallel layers. Gneiss, schist, slate, example. Non-foliated, rocks that contain quartz and feldspar. In foliated, it contains mica and ferromagnesium. In non-foliated, it contains quartz and feldspar. Example, anthracite. Granular. Rocks comprising mostly of equidimensional grains. Example, quartz marble. Equi means equal. So based on texture, three types: foliated, non-foliated, granular. So next we'll study one by one about the rocks. Nature is crystalline calcareous metamorphic rock, marble. It is a crystalline calcareous metamorphic rock. It is generally white in color. It is composed chiefly of mineral calcite, that is calcium carbonate, or more rarely dolomite. Texture is, grain size is so small that it cannot be distinguished by the eye. Origin, marbles are formed as a result of metamorphism of limestones. So when limestone undergoes metamorphism, marble is formed. It is used in construction of monument building, flooring, etc. The name is marble. Taj Mahal is constructed from the rock marble. So in this, important point is it is crystalline calcareous metamorphic rock. It is chiefly composed of calcium carbonate. Grain size is very small. It is formed from the metamorphism of limestone. It is used for monument and touring purpose. The name is marble. Next one, quartzite. It is hard, dense, siliceous metamorphic rock, usually light in color. It is hard, dense, siliceous metamorphic rock, usually light in color. It is composed essentially of quartz. Majority, more than 90% contains quartz. Texture, compact rock of interlocking quartz grains. Quartzites are derived from sandstone. When sandstone undergoes metamorphism, your quartzite is formed. Sandstone is nothing but silica, that is sand grains, quartz, greater than 90%. Also the quartzite same, under the influence of contact and dynamic metamorphism. It is used in building and road construction, name of the rock, quartzite. So nature, hard, dense, siliceous, metamorphic rock. The essential minerals are quartz. It is compact rock, interacting quartz grains. It is derived from sandstone under the influence of contact and dynamic metamorphism. Used in building and road construction, the name is quartzite. Gneiss. A gneiss is a coarse grained, irregular banded metamorphic rock, usually light in color. Quartz and feldspar are common in gneiss, occur together in light colored bands alternate with dark bands of flaky ferromagnesium minerals such as biotite, mica, and hornblende. So you can see in this rock picture, there is alternate bands of white, black, white, black, white, black. So this is the So you can easily find from this structure the difference between granite and a gneiss rock. Okay, gneiss occur together in light color bands alternate with dark bands. Okay, so grain size are coarse in nature. They are generally the result of advanced stages of metamorphism of variety of rocks, such as sandstone, granite. When granite undergoes metamorphism, gneiss is formed. It is used in building stone, road stone. The name is gneiss. It is, so I repeat, gneiss is coarse grain, irregular, banded, metamorphic rock, bands, white, black, or alternate bands. Quartz feldspar is the mineral composition, grain size coarse, it results of advanced stage of metamorphism from granite. It is used in building stone, road stone, the name is gneiss. Next one is slate. It is an extremely fine grained, low grade metamorphic rock. They have remarkable property called slaty cleavage, color gray to black. You can see this is the cleavage of slate. By this, like you are in notebook pages, different pages are there. Same way, there are, you can thin sheets or slaty cleavage you can find in, or you can cut from the slate. So they have remarkable property called slaty cleavage. Slates are composed of very fine grain mixture of micas and chloride with some quartz and feldspar. The important minerals are mica and chloride. Slates are very fine grain rocks which show slaty cleavage. Special property is slaty cleavage. Majority of slates are formed by dynamic metamorphism of shales. It is used for construction purpose locally as roofing and paving material. The name is slate. So slate is an extremely fine grade, low grade metamorphic rock. Okay. It is composed of mica and chloride with some amount of quartz and feldspar. It is a fine grain rock with slaty cleavage. It is formed from dynamic metamorphism of shales. It is used locally for construction purpose as roofing and paving material. The name is slate. Thank you.